So welcome to this short video demo of how to tune, sweep, and optimize data files such as S-parameter files in Agilent ADS. The scenario I'm going to use to demonstrate this is a backplane with two daughter cards shown here. I'm going to assume I'm trying to pick the optimum connectors to join these daughter cards and backplane together, and that the connectors are characterized by a set of S-parameter files. I have a number of candidate connectors and I want to pick which pair of connectors gives me the best performance. So let's see how we do this in ADS. So this schematic represents that photograph I showed you. Here I have a stimulus, which is a pair of impulses, and the daughter card. Connector A is represented by this file list that I'll show you in a moment. The backplane is represented by a transmission line. Connector B is represented by an independent file list. In general, you can have as many file lists as you like. And the right-hand daughter card is represented by this transmission line, and it's followed by a load impedance. So the connectors are represented by these data file lists. What I can do is add as many components as I like. I can browse for the manufacturer's S-parameter files, cut and paste those as much as I want. I can do that for the right hand connector too. I have an independent list of components for the right hand connector. I have an index variable which indexes through the sets of file names. I've made this index variable tunable and optimizable in both cases. The simulation I'm going to run is transient, and I have this measurement equation here that measures the differential voltage at the output. My goal is going to be minimize the transient response after the main pulse comes through. In my case, it's about 4.95 nanoseconds. After the main pulse comes through, I'm going to try and minimize this expression, which is the kind of residual ringing after the main pulse. I'm going to try and minimize that to zero in a least squares sense. The optimization control I'm using is discrete. It's going to tune all the optimization variables, which in my case is two, and use all the goals. In my case, it's just one goal. So you may be wondering, how are we going to run S parameters in a transient simulation? As I mentioned, all the connectors are going to be represented by these four-port S-parameter files, which are defined in the frequency domain. So what we're going to do is we're going to use the ADS Transient Convolution Simulator. It has this convolution tab that enables you to import frequency domain components, and using an inverse FFT technique, it lets you run frequency domain components in a transient time domain simulation. That's our transient convolution simulator. Kind of goes beyond what regular SPICE can do. Now before I run the automatic optimization, I would like to run this manual optimization that we call tuning. The reason is it's good to see visually what's going on before you let the optimizer do the heavy lifting of finding the actual optimum point. You can often get some insight into what's going on by using this tuning mode. So I'm going to deactivate the automatic optimization, open the tuning dialog box. What I like to do is to arrange the windows so I can see the output, the simulation messages in the tuning window all in one. And currently I can see the impulse response here is the main peak followed by these ringing type of things. I can zoom in, see what's going on here, put a marker on this one. Main pulse comes in at 4.95 nanoseconds, and this ringing pulse comes in around 5 nanoseconds. So as I run this tuning control, I can step through the various files and look at the response of the ringing of various settings. Find some settings are better than others. So this looks like a good way of optimizing the connectors, but it could be tedious to step through all 130 combinations. So I'm going to use the optimizer to do that for me automatically. I'm going to close out of tuning. And re-enable my optimization controller and run the simulation automatically. So the simulation takes a couple of minutes to run, but then it finds the optimum solution here. The impulse response is almost perfect. And that's it. The optimum connector for the right left-hand side is connector number 6. For the right-hand side is connector number 7. We can see which connectors those are. We've optimized our design. Thank you for your attention.